So if I move the chain select away from them, boom, nothing. Nothing at all. I don't know why that got automated, but I'll delete this. So maybe in this case, I would start with the sub bass, and maybe it'll be helpful again. The most sort of fundamental foundational elements on top. Getting on my nerves. Some of the randomizations are not exactly my thing, which brings me to another idea. I'm going to show you guys how, we've got all this crazy stuff on that main analog track. If I go and adjust the chain selector there. Actually, getting a little ahead of myself, what I first want to explain, because this is a bit confusing and is really important as you get deeper into racks, nesting racks within racks within racks, is how the macro assignment works. So it's essentially a nested hierarchy. What does that mean? Okay, so if I want to assign, say, this pitch, the cycler. To a macro, well, ideally, I would want to have it assigned to one of the macros in my top instrument rack. But if we go to the map mode on this device, only parameters within the macro below it are available for mapping to instrument rack at the top. So I'm going to get back in here. Select between the different MIDI patterns contained within, and then I'll map this to macro 2, call that my pitch, and I'll need to go to the macro mappings for this one. I'm going to constrain the range. I don't want it to go below, what was the default, 48? Going through the C minor here, but I'm going to hold down the Alt key to copy one into this particular chain just to make sure. Yeah. Huh. Sounds a little funny, probably just because it's so high. Alright, and then let's see, the chord pulsar, maybe. Via the context menu rather than go in and out of map mode. I'm sure you guys can use your imaginations. But I am again going to constrain the range. I don't want it to go below 13%. instrument rack itself can have, say, the filter of the analog mapped. And I'm going to start putting instrument parameters along the bottom. We'll call it analog. Okay, and then, now that I've mapped those MIDI effect rack parameters to their own macros, those macros then in turn are available for mapping to the macros of the map, to the macros of the rack one step above it. Does that make sense? Okay, so I'm going to map the pattern chain here. So I'll call this okay, and then we'll do this to macro 3, and this to macro 4. I can leave map mode, and now, even with everything else minimized, just looking at the macros, the parent rack here at the very top, we can do the parent, the pattern chain macro. And that high pitch. Now, I'm not in my studio, so I don't have a controller handy. So I'm doing this all by mouse right now, not quite so elegant. And I can go back to just the sub